to this man that will read Surah Al-Kawthar on his, for his soul. So this rich man, he said, I assign this person to take all the profits of my businesses on the condition that he reads Surah Al-Kawthar for me once a year. And you know, Surah Al-Kawthar is the shortest surah in Holy Quran. أَسْتَعِذُ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّا عَطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَانِيَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرِ. So he says, this man said, and he says رَأَيْتُ, that means it was in front of him. He said, I saw that this man said, I am not asking anything from this person except that he reads Surah Al-Kawthar and he sends it, send the rewards to my soul, and then he can get all the money that my businesses generate. Grand Sheikh is saying that this kind of action, this man was trying to show how much he has respect for Holy Quran. That nothing in this world is comparable to the respect he has in his heart to Holy Quran. That he was ready to give all what he makes from this dunya in a year just for one Holy Quran, a surah of Holy Quran to be recited. This is the ihtiram, this is his respect to Holy Quran. And this same man is saying, even if I had the money of the whole world, I would give it to this man so he can read Surah Al-Kawthar for me when I die. Because Quran Kareem goes to the soul of a human being. Some people, they are against that. Some Muslims, they have come out that they said you cannot send Quran to soul of a departed. So Alhamdulillah, from Azhar, and my father told me about that. They came fatwa that if you can do Hajj for somebody after they die, you can definitely read Quran. Because Hajj is about prayer. In prayer you read Quran. Because you cannot perform Hajj if you don't do two rak'ah after tawaf. In these two rak'ah after tawaf, you are standing, reading Fatiha, and reading, if you want to read like قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ and قُلْ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدٌ, that is recommended. But you can read any Quran, Kareem, in these two rak'ahs. After you make the tawaf, you stand behind Maqami Ibrahim, and you make two rak'ahs. And that's how your tawaf is accepted. Otherwise, it's deficient, naqis. It's not complete. So in these two rak'ahs, you are reading Quran. So if you are able to give, to make Hajj for a deceased one, that means the sawab of the Quran is going to the soul of that deceased one, because you are reading it during the two rak'ahs of tawaf, after tawaf. So this man is saying, even if I had the whole money of this world, I would give it to this man just to read one surah of Holy Quran once a year. Not every day, once a year. He said, وَأَن تَكُونَ لِي نَعْمَةَ الْقُرْآنِ وَلَوْ فِي أَقْصَرِ سُورَةٍ فَأَنَّهُ شَرَفٌ لِي. For me to have the favor, the reward of Holy Quran, even if it's the smallest surah, smallest chapter, it is an endless honor for me. To know Holy Quran and to recite Holy Quran is an endless honor. If I had all the treasures of this earth, I would have given it to them for them to read me that surah. In Holy Quran, it's mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on the day of judgment, if I can remember the verse correctly, لَفْتَدَوْ بِهِ. Now, I don't remember the verse from the beginning, but if they are given, if they give, ومثله معه, أو in another آية بمثل الأرض ذهبا, بملء الأرض ذهبا, if they will give the weight or the amount of this earth in gold, or if they will give all this earth with what's in it and multiples of what's in it, ما تقبل منه, we will not be accepted on the day of judgment. So this man is saying, I give it now, everything. But send me the rewards of Holy Quran. That means Holy Quran is more important than this whole world and what's in it. This man understood Holy Quran. So read Holy Quran. Memorize Holy Quran. Kiss Holy Quran. Kiss the papers. Mawlana Sheikh Nazim used to close Holy Quran like this and kiss the papers. Kiss the papers out of love. Love of Kalamullah. Love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. And you get happiness from Holy Quran. Memorize. Memorize. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give more power to the teachers of Holy Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be happy with the teachers of Holy Quran. And give them more power to instill that love of Holy Quran. But I have something for them. I read a story of a teacher of Holy Quran. A man came to him and he's reciting Holy Quran on him. He recited it one time and it was okay. He went, that man came again and recited it again on the teacher. The teacher yelled at him. He said, what are you doing? You made recitation of Holy Quran a work for you, a job for you to recite? See what's in it. Understand what's telling you. It's not only about recitation of Holy Quran, which is the problem that we have nowadays. People only compete in how they recite Holy Quran. It's not about competing and reciting one time and twice and three times or four times. It's about understanding what it's telling you. What is Holy Quran telling you? Okay, you memorize it, but what did it tell you? I don't know.
Oh.
You cannot say, I don't know. So when you're memorizing Holy Quran, the teachers have to tell people what's in it. What is it telling them? Not only recite and move. No. Recite and do. عَلْ وَعَمَلْ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, عَمَلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always said, the one that believed in the holy books and did what the holy books told them. There is knowledge and there's amal. So you cannot be alim without amal, you cannot be knowledge without act, and you cannot have act without knowledge. And that's the problem with so many people nowadays. They only want to know the spiritual knowledge of Sufism, but we don't do anything in Sharia. And how? Or they want to do Sharia, which is good, but they don't make themselves higher to know more, to have more alim and more adab. Not only in Muslims, but also in other religions too. They only want to get the one and not the other one. No, you have to do knowledge and you have to act on what you have learned. Inshallah. So, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim is saying, Holy Quran is the biggest favor. And it's much better than all the treasures of this world. So, to learn Holy Quran is better than making $1 million. Tell your children that. To know Holy Quran. Nowadays they say, oh, we don't have time to read. Where are you going to? Oh, I have a party to attend to. I cannot sit in zikr. Why? What are you going to do? Oh, I have a movie to go to. That is more important, or this is more important? But we don't know. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. And make us always together, inshallah. Keep our circle stronger. Learn adab from our shuyukh. And embrace Holy Quran to the fullest, inshallah. We can learn its secrets, its meanings, and that is the way to Jannah. Quran is the tariq ila al-Jannah. Tariq al-Jannah, Quran. There's no other tariq. It is said that ulum al-kutub al-arba'a fi al-Quran al-Karim. The knowledges of all four books are in Holy Quran. So Torah, Injil, Psalms are all in the Holy Quran. You don't have to go, because Sahaba were asking Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, do we read Torah? Do we read? No, there's no need. They're all in Holy Quran. Because they are showing the true ones. We don't know nowadays who is following what. But all ulum, all the knowledges of the four books are in Holy Quran. And it is said, and this is what Awliyaullah have quoted, all the ulum of Holy Quran is in Surah Al-Fatiha. Seven verses. وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ. Seven verses of Holy Quran. If you recite these seven verses of Holy Quran, of Fatiha, Surah Al-Fatiha, you close the seven gates of hell. every time you recite the seven verses of Surah Al-Fatiha, the seven gates of hell are shut off. They're closed. Why? Because in Holy Quran you are saying, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. Sirat al-Mustaqim doesn't go to Jahannam. You are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guidance. So guidance does not lead you to hellfire. So every time you read Surah Al-Fatiha, seven verses, seven gates of hell are closed when you read Surah Al-Fatiha, seven. They said, the secrets of Surah Al-Fatiha, they are all in Bismillah. How many letters are Bismillah, Nadir? Bismillah. Count.
Seven
verses of Holy Quran, the knowledge of seven verses, are in the seven letters of Bismillah. By the name of Allah. If you say by the name of Allah, you would know all of Holy Quran. They can say, oh, wait. Rasulullah was told to say, Iqra' bismi rabbik. Read in the name of your Lord. So if you say Bismillah, you are reading Holy Quran. So these secrets are contained in Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Bismillah, seven letters. Seven letters. And it is said that the knowledge of that is in harful ba, in the letter of ba. Ba. These are deeper knowledges. And the secrets of that are in the dot of ba. The one dot. Because it's inshallah, some other time we can explain. These are deep stuff. We have people that are. I don't want people to object. Slowly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow, inshallah, Mawlana Sheikh will send what is needed. So what is needed is this. This is more than enough. So Surah Al-Fatiha, if you read it, you close the seven doors of hell. Because you are asking for Sirat Mustaqim. Seven. Inshallah. So read Surah Al-Fatiha, don't forget. Every day, read it. We read it seven times every day. This is what Mawlana Sheikh has ordered us to do. Don't lose Adab al-Tariqa. If Mawlana Sheikh is saying, do Adab al-Tariqa every day. Try to do it as much as you can. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Wa min Allah tawfiq bi hurmat al-habib wa bi sirri Surah Al-Fatiha.